I don't know if you understand this, Wendy. He has got shit on his mind. I mean, the dude is trying to save your fucking life, save your kid's life, and save his life. He's got shit on his mind. I'm just saying. I'm back with another drunk reaction. Today I'm drinking some more Cinerator, which is one of my many cinnamon whiskeys. And we're back for episode 9, the penultimate episode of season 1 of Ozark. It's called Coffee Black. And I'm steadfastly refusing to read the synopsis. Don't want to take any chance of spoiling myself. Okay, so have we gotten the flashback bullshit out of the way? Can we get on with the actual plot now? Thank you.
I got it.
Thanks, man.
Jesus Christ.
I'll call you later.
You promise you keep that safe?
Holy shit.
Promise. See ya.
What the fuck is happening with this creepy motherfucker, man? I will say this, though. His creepiness has achieved a level where I actually remember his character name, Jonah. Like, hey, I drink. I don't remember every character name, so you gotta be an interesting motherfucker for me to remember. Oh, let me pause. Okay, so we've got a gun, we've got a broken TV, looks like a fly, and some money. Well, that could pretty much be any fucking episode, man. You know, I mean, at least the fly and some money, anyway. Is it a broken TV, or is it just a TV picture of a tree branch?
Yeah, the two of you are up to your ball sacks in drama. Tell you that.
I don't think she's up to her ball sacks, buddy. What have you heard? This spot
right here. Pleasure, Tim.
Mason burned it down?
It was a gesture, Martin. And some people understand the importance of gestures.
You didn't convince Mason of shit.
Pausing? No. I do find it interesting, and I'm not saying this as a criticism of the show, you know, because sometimes, like in like House, for instance, all the doctors run every test, and, you know, you're not, like, when you're a doctor, you're not, like, authorized, you don't have the training to run certain kinds of tests, like, you know, maybe you can do an LP, but you can't do an MRI, maybe you can do an MRI, but you can't do, like, a whatever, you know, like, there's, like, some of these are really complicated tests that require a lot of, like, training and retraining and learn new software and shit. So, and I've seen a lot of doctors complain about the fact that not doctors don't run every test. A different doctor would come in and run a certain test, for instance. Now, part of the show mythology is that House doesn't trust anybody but his own doctors run tests. But still, you can't, even a better example is NCSI shows, you know, with all the forensics. They'll show the main characters running these forensics tests. And they never do that. They, you know, you have underlings, you have other people who work and to do certain kinds of tests and do certain kinds of jobs and responsibilities, in other words. Long way of saying, because on a TV budget, you can only have so many speaking characters. You can only have so many people on screen. There's just, you only have so much budget. You can't, so you can't show a lab tech who would have two lines who would actually be doing a job. You can't do it. It's like, it's impossible on a TV budget. So, a lot, that's why you'll see that. It's not really a blooper, but basically it's just a TV error. It's like, it's a thing that, like, you know, isn't realistic, but there's no way to get around it on a TV budget. I don't think that's what's going on here with this guy, because this guy's running his own fucking booth. We see him running his farm, you know, and he must have minions who could come out here on the fucking farmer's market or whatever they're doing and run the booth for him. But he's a fucking micromanager. He strikes me as a, I think this actually speaks to his character. I don't think it is a thing where they didn't want to pay a different actor to do that or have him, like, sitting on his porch or something. You know, I think they're speaking to character here. They're showing this dude is a fucking control freak micromanager who wants to personally handle every situation. You know, which is probably why his wife is this fucking hitman, you know? You know what I'm saying? I just find it, like, a very interesting character trait. Rather than the typical, we're trying to save budget by having one character do everything. Because if this dude's like, he's a fucking millionaire and shit, he ain't got time to handle every personal aspect of every business. But that seems like that's the kind of character he actually is. I just find that interesting. You know, thought it worth noting.
Be grateful it was only your church that went up in flames.
I think we all understand each other now.
Come in.
Russ, stop. I need you to hear something.
Is he gonna fucking tell who he is?
He won't try to kill
Oh my god. Why is everybody on this show like Tony Stark? I am Iron Man. I am a money launderer. I am an FBI agent. We're the FBI. We're investigating your family. Who's that sitting in front of your house? Like, everybody in this show is Tony Stark. Ain't nobody trying to keep a secret about nothing, man. So, that's a no on running away together, I guess. He's kind of slow, but I guess he gets there in the end.
Class B felony in Missouri is 5 to 15 years.
What the fuck
years.
Are you talking about? What?
You help me get out. And they will cut you a deal.
He's not going to be joining Miss anytime soon, is he? Well, first got a head like a rock.
She told me she did it.
That's hearsay. Without real evidence.
Not necessarily. I'm not, it's too long to get into. Hearsay doesn't mean what Hollywood thinks hearsay means. Hearsay is used in court all the fucking time.
Just drink some water. And when I do, I advise you to remember you're dealing with a federal agent.
Yeah, this ain't domestic abuse anymore, motherfucker. This is assault of federal officers. You're used to that domestic abuse bullshit.
Is my phone a big fight?
No.
Oh, it did.
Well, he's going to want to know where her money is, so this is a fucking problem.
Rachel, you let me back into the blue cat to finish my business, or I'm going to come for you. You understand what I'm saying? And no one will find
it. Hey, Marty knows how to coerce a motherfucker, man. I'll give him that, man. He knows how to coerce a motherfucker. He is one magnificent bastard, man. Just let him fucking in.
Just at the end of the week.
Yeah, it's always just till the end of the week, isn't it?
Yeah.
That's what Golden Corral said. Just till the end of the week. You can eat here just till the end of the week and you won't gain any weight. Yeah, right. We see how that turned out.
Bury the hatchet.
She'll bury you, motherfucker. That bury the hatchet thing's always creeped me out. Because the hatchet ends up getting buried in your back. Man, he's cleaned up. Jesus. Being a snitch has made his hygiene go up a notch.
I've shit to fold.
That's right. Don't implicate yourself, baby. I'm pulling for you. I don't know why I'm rooting for the criminals, because, you know, I mean, but they've got me rooting for the criminals. You know, that's just how they suck you in.
I'm fucking happy I did what you asked.
He didn't record shit.
Who the fuck is this? Her plan to kill Marty. Her role in the laundering process.
I'm not talking to you.
You're only talking
to me. Like I said, you didn't get shit.
Fuck you.
So, Jesus. How fast does this dumb son of a bitch end up in the bottom of the lake?
What? You're a fucking animal.
Man, mixing business and pleasure is all this son of a bitch does, man. That's all he does.
If we weren't stuck, would we still be together?
Hey, I don't know if you understand this, Wendy. He has got shit on his mind! I mean, the dude is trying to save your fucking life, save your kid's life, and save his life. He's got shit on his mind.
Thank you for not taking
I'm just saying.
Last night about my mother's funeral request, and I definitely think I'm going to need that money.
Buddy, I'm really, really sorry to hear about Eugenia. Your mother was a real fine woman.
Thank you.
Yeah, listen,
here's the thing. Like, I know this is Hollywood bullshit, right? When my dad passed away, the funeral home gave me 9 months to give them a dime. You know what I mean? Because shit was tied up in escrow, you know, all this stuff. Like, I don't know if escrow is the right word. It was tied up in the estate. You know, and so they gave me 9 months. I didn't have to pay a fucking dime for 9 months. So this dude, this, you know, it's obviously Hollywood bullshit, you know? But hey, crank up the pressure. That's what we like, you know? Pressure increases the drama.
How can I pay for this?
I'll call the bank. I'll get a credit increase. Funerals are what, 10 grand?
Oh, Jesus, you sweet summer child.
The full buffet, did you decide on a head count?
Between 100 and 100.
Full buffet.
That many?
Oh, Jesus fucking Christ. Oh, my God.
Rotary.
That's going to run you 5 grand right there, man.
To be safe. Our compression services for the carriage you requested runs $19,900.
Holy fucking shit!
I brought some of these.
This bitch is trying to take it all with her, man. They say you can't take it with you.
What are these?
this crazy bitch is trying to fucking take it all with her.
Our loved ones and keeps them with us.
You better set this motherfucker right. See, like I said, my funeral home that I dealt with, man, like they weren't these kind of fucking douchebags trying to exploit grieving people.
What's the total?
Pre-tax, she's going to have to put some bass in her voice. I can see that. Holy fucking shit! What do you need? God damn, man!
Visitation.
They ain't using no lubricant whatsoever, man. They're going in dry. Of course. Jesus Christ!
Of course.
No peanut butter or nothing, man. Motherfucker.
Hey, Harry. God, that's gotta be hard.
Oh, shit. This is gonna be their next... She just put this shit into their next fucking laundry scam. Oh, my God, man. Oh, you magnificent bastard. She is on Marty's fucking level, man. I just realized it in this moment. She is on Marty's level. You're fucking brilliant.
What if I had an alternate solution?
She's a fucking genius. She is on Marty's level. I just fucking realized that, man.
There's no hitman out front.
Because Del got paid. That hitman was waiting, man. He was like six steps away, man. Del ain't fucking around, dude. Del is not fucking around. He had that fucking hitman waiting six steps away. Not even in a fucking hotel room down the block, right? What an asshole. Del's a son of a bitch, man. That is fucking hysterical. The second that money dropped, the hitman takes off. You fucking asshole.
Just say you'll try it again.
You're acting fucking weird.
You just want to make sure you're holding up your end.
You wearing a wire, you son of a bitch.
I never wanted to kill Marty Bird. That was your idea.
I think she just figured it out.
And frankly, I don't know why you want to kill him so bad.
You can't ask smart Ruth. We're seeing magnificent bastards all over the fucking place. Marty slinging that big dick energy. Wendy slinging that big dick energy. And now we got Ruth slinging that big dick energy. Man, these motherfuckers are smart, man. You better try harder. You better pack your lunch. While this brain trust tries to figure this shit out, I'm going to get another drink. Oh, I forgot to mention this before I started again. Tennessee Fire. I switched to Tennessee Fire.
Okay, yeah, we'll just tie that up in a second.
Yeah, delivery is a massive amount of fucking cash, I imagine. Yeah. I wonder how much cash is this time. 80 million? He did say 10 times.
I'll need you to get down here.
Yeah, that kid's all over this shit. Hey, stop staring like a serial killer, kid. That dude don't give a shit, boy. So it's kids. I guess it's about fear. I think I'm starting to vibe into this kid's head. It's about fear. I thought it was about aggression. See, I totally misread the whole scenario with the guns and shit, all that creepy ass shit. It's about fear. It's not about aggression. That's very interesting to me. That actually elevates, like, what I think about the kid, you know? You know, it's very interesting to me, like, how often fear can be mistaken for aggression. Think about that. Somebody has a gun, you think it's about aggression, but really it's about fear. That's interesting.
You do not talk about this. Not with anyone.
I don't know, man. I just don't know if these morons especially can handle this, man.
Why not?
Yeah. I mean, I've been to the Dexter School doing nefarious shit, and you're supposed to shop at different stores so that you don't look like a fucking serial killer, man. Jesus.
I love these.
I mean, why don't you just buy a body bag, too? So it's literally Chekhov's gun. See, here's the thing I've noticed since I've gotten old. People don't notice old people, but old people notice shit, you know? Yep, you're about to get this kid killed, ain't you?
What are you doing?
I'll tell you what, this really feels like a penultimate episode.
Tonight?
Man, there is so much on her face. Oh my god. Here's your $80 million in cardboard boxes. I bet that shit would be heavy, man. We got this. Season 2 is fully financed. Well, get to lifting, man. What's up?
Okay, one more box to go.
I'm surprised. Holy shit, man. Holy shit, that just looks awesome. I'm sorry. I'm surprised he didn't fold Ruth in this. I guess you don't want Ruth to know where the place is. You only can trust her but so much. Two dumbasses walk into a bar. Oh my god. She got his ass. Holy shit. Damn, Ruth. Damn, Ruth, it's like that. Damn, Ruth, it's like I did not fucking see that coming. God damn. I did not fucking see that coming. Holy shit. Holy fucking shit, man. This drink's for you, Ruth. You are one cold bitch, man. Hey, it had to be done, man. It had to be fucking done. She's cooked those motherfuckers, boy. God damn, I did not see that coming. That is so fucking awesome, man. Ruth is taking care of business, boy.
You knew they were coming after you because somebody fucking did this on purpose, Marty.
Shut up, Rachel. Don't talk in front of the cartel, man. Shut the fuck up.
You'll be okay.
Yeah.
Right? Well, I think Rachel knows what she's dealing with now, man. That dude will blow your fucking head off. She's drinking like a motherfucker, man. Just give her a hug. She needs it. Poor girl.
Did it work?
Yeah, why am I feeling so much sympathy for a cold-blooded murderer?
I couldn't have him kill you.
Oh, give her a hug, you cold son of a bitch. I'm not shipping him. Don't even take it like that. I'm just saying, man. Give her some fucking comfort, you asshole. That's right, goddammit. Give her some fucking comfort, you asshole. That's what I'm talking about. Yeah. Don't nobody want none of this right now. Ah, the shot, TV. I see you, TV show. Oh, Jason Bateman directed this shit. Yeah, of course he did. Man, I'll just say this. I had no idea Jason Bateman was this good of a director. Yeah, like, he's fucking amazing. He is awesome. Like, I'm gonna, like, once I'm done with, like, so that, like, Google searches won't spoil me on some shit, once I've done the whole run of Ozark, I'm gonna see if he's directed anything else, because the dude's awesome. Anyway, that was a great episode, penultimate episode. Man, a lot of fucking shit happened, man. You have a slow throwback episode, and then boom, man, they hauled ass in this episode. So, but what's interesting, I wonder if this is going to be like Game of Thrones, where everything culminates in the penultimate episode. You know, the episode 9 of Game of Thrones is always the most exciting episode of the season. And then in the 10th episode of the season, in the final episode, they would actually basically wrap up the themes for the season and set the table for the next season. You know, I wonder if that's what's going to be like on this show. Like, you know, we're not going to have very much exciting shit because it seems like most things have been wrapped up. And now they're going to set the table for the second season. So I have a feeling that's what's going to happen.